Every time I do this, I get a bunch of hate mail. Bring it. Let's go to New Orleans. All right. The FBI has opened an investigation into sex abuse in the Roman Catholic Church in New Orleans going back decades. All right. The New Orleans cases under review allege abuse by clergy during trips to Mississippi camps or amusement parks in Texas and Florida. And while some claims are decades old, Mann Act violations notably have no statute of limitation. We had to fight for that law, by the way. It's been a long road, and just the fact that someone this high up believes us means the world to us, said a former altar boy who alleged his assailant took him on trips to Colorado, Florida, and abused him. This was starting in the 1970s. He was only in the fifth grade. Federal investigators are now considering whether to seek access to thousands of secret church documents produced by lawsuits and shielded by sweeping confidentiality orders in the bankruptcy, according to those familiar with the probe, who were not authorized to discuss with the AP on condition of anonymity. Those records are said to document years of abuse claims, interviews with accused clergy, and a pattern of church leaders transferring problem priests without reporting their crimes to law enforcement. Now, let me say this, okay? I don't give a damn if you come to work with a priest collar on. I don't care that you've been ordained by some secular group. And I don't give a damn if you say you are called by God. When you touch the children, you are a monster. You will forever be a monster in my book. So while the FBI may still be considering what to do, I know exactly what to do with it. Put up his picture. Among the priests under federal scrutiny in New Orleans, they call it scrutiny, is Lawrence Hecker, 90-year-old, removed from the ministry in 2002 following accusations he abused countless children. Hecker is accused of abusing children decades ago on out-of-state trips, and other claims against him range from fondling all the way to rape. Keep his picture up. As I have said before, and I will say again, the Catholic Church is nothing more than another company, another corporation, greedy, corrupt, hiding the reality of who they are. The character of that company is defined by those they protect. That's any company, including the Catholic Church. Now, damn it, if you don't like it, fine. But I'm telling you the truth. Are there some good Catholic people in the world? Of course there are. Just like there are some good cops in the world. But you're not that good if you allow the bad to define you. This should have been exposed by the culture of the industry if the industry was righteous. Meaning, if your culture is more right than wrong, when there's something wrong, the right culture will excommunicate it. But when it's the other way around, the wrong will remain and permeate. Put up the next picture. His name is Patrick Wadeney, a priest charged last year by state prosecutors after he admitted to molesting a teenager in 2013. His 2020 removal from the ministry came amid an investigation into inappropriate text messages he sent to a student. Had been doing it a long time. They got him for one, but not the others. Let's talk about the legal hurdles in the past, okay? The issue has always been determining what is the federal crime, said Peter G. Strasser, the former US attorney in New Orleans who declined to bring charges in 2018 after the archdiocese published a list of 57 credibly accused clergy. Now remember, this archdiocese did the right thing, made it public. It was a roster, an AP analysis found had been undercounted by at least 20 names. Strasser said he naively believed a federal case might be possible only to encounter a host of roadblocks, including the complexities of putting the church on trial for charges like conspiracy. Let's be very clear, the reason why he did not prosecute it is because he was politically scared and not a leader. Do you understand that rappers are prosecuted under the RICO Act, state statute RICO Acts, not even the federal government one? They figure out creative ways to prosecute gang members, rappers, black folks all the time. School teachers were prosecuted under the RICO Act in the cheating scandal in the city of Atlanta. Yeah. But you can't prosecute actual preachers who are committing child molestation? There's more. Louisiana joined 24 states that have enacted look back windows intended to allow unresolved crimes of sex abuse, no matter how old, to be brought in civil court, but with few exceptions. Most notably, a former deacon charged with rape. The accused clergy have escaped criminal consequences, even at the local level. Cases have been hamstrung by statutes of limitation and the political sensitivity of prosecuting the church. Let's be clear, this is corruption. I don't give a damn what they call it, political sensitivity. That is corruption. Children are victimized by a company of men who have power and influence, and the government did nothing to very little about it. Jessica, thoughts here?
Yeah, if you're out there watching this and you're Catholic and this makes you uncomfortable, it should. I grew up in an Italian American family. There were a lot of people who were Catholics and a lot of people left the church. You really have to ask yourself, is the church representing your spiritual values and your principles? And you can be religious and spiritual and keep those values in your relationship with a higher power and still not support a corrupt institution. And I really think that people within the Catholic Church need to look within themselves and think, am I supporting a corrupt institution? Is it time for me to leave? And I think many people upon reflection will conclude yes. This is also a super interesting case where they're applying an old law that was created for unjust reasons, right? Law and justice are absolutely not the same, but it can be applied in a way that protects these altar boys and brings about justice. And that's really interesting, right? The Mann Act, also known as the White Slave Traffic Act, was meant to prevent white women from crossing state lines with immigrant men in the 1910s. And they're relying on the Commerce Clause. They can now apply this law to prevent, you know, preachers and pastors from going on these trips, these priests going on these trips with these young altar boys. That's an interesting dynamic to apply a law that was created for unjust reasons to bring about justice.
Very well said. We're gonna follow this entire case. Typically, you have no arrest when there's this big splash, but maybe the time is changing.